Hello, my beautiful bitterroots, and welcome to my channel, and seeing my ugly mug, and my annoying voice. Yeah, okay. Today, and I know it's really late, but I got my December empties, and it spilled over into another container, because I got a lot of big products right here. So, first of all, let's go with these. I've got a couple Melaleuca cleaning products for you. And I want to show you, it's really dirty, so ignore the dirtiness. I need to wash it. But this is Melaleuca's Tub and Tile. And the reason why I say wash it is because Melaleuca has their concentrates where you fill up this bottle. So, there's a little bit left in this, but it's to the point where it doesn't want to spray when you spray kind of deal. So I'm going to refill this. Yeah, it lasted a long time. If you guys want an all-natural product that you don't have to worry about your kids grabbing and drinking, yeah, they'll get a tummy ache, but it won't kill them. Melaleuca cleaning products is great. Great, great, great. It's all eco-friendly. Just good products. This doesn't smell the greatest. It kind of stinks, in my opinion, but that's all right. But it's got a funky smell to it, but it works. It works very well. Next one from Melaleuca is their clear power window washing thing. This is kept in the bathroom, which is why it's kind of gross too. Lissa uses it for the mirrors in the bathrooms because her job is cleaning bathrooms. And again, I've got a refill. So yeah, I'll be refilling this product too. Next, I've got Pledge Multi-Surface Streak-Free Spray. It's for metal, wood, glass, and electronics. There's a little bit left in here, but again, it's to the point where you have to hold it a certain way to spray it to get anything out. I do like this product. I am trying to go more eco-friendly, so this is just some of the stuff I had. Would I buy it again? I don't know. It depends if I could find a good eco-friendly one to replace it. And I think I have, you know, I do use Simple Green. Yeah, this is for electronics on top of it, so maybe I would buy it for the electronics aspect of it, but I don't know. Next, I've got Oust Surface Disinfectant Air Sanitizer. We don't use it to sanitize the air. We have them in the bathroom to spray down the toilet. Yeah, between cleanings. So I do have got another one. I've got their lemon scent in the bathrooms now. This is their outdoor scent. They smell good. Okay, then we've got some candles. So this is Welcome Home Old West Handmade Candle Company, made in Dillon, Montana. It's a natural soy candle. It smelled really good. I think the scent was huckleberry, because Montana is famous for huckleberry. One thing I want to talk about with you guys, one of the YouTubers that I watch was talking about the black and if it in the cause of the blackness is chemicals, and that's actually not true. The reason why you get black soot on your candle is because your wick needs to be trimmed. It's too long. So that's what brings out the black soot. This is an all-natural soy candle with a cotton wick, and as you can see, it makes a big mess. And that's because you have to go in there and you have to trim the cotton ones in particular to like a fourth of an inch. You cut it right down to there's barely anything showing above, because it will keep growing, and if you have them burning for a long period of time, you have to blow them out, wait till they cool, trim the wick, so that way you don't get wick inside the wax and making it look all weird. So yeah, just make sure you trim the wick down when you use it, and that helps with the sootiness. I just let this one burn down to the metal, so that's why it got a lot of soot around the the edge of this. So I do like this. This had a great scent throw, but this is handmade. I don't know if you could buy it online. I lied. You can buy it at MontanaCandleWorks.com. All one word. So yeah, great candle, lasted a long time, great scent throw. And I don't remember how much I paid for it. It was a long time ago. This one, as I told you, I have a thing about peeling labels. And I tried to peel this label and it didn't want to peel. But it's Harmony Knit Lane Candle Collection. This is in Homemade Preserves. There's quite a bit of wax left over in this. This glass is so much thinner than this glass. So much thinner. This is a very high quality glass. This is very thin, so when the wick moves over, I blow it out because it starts cracking, and I've had these things explode on me. This didn't have a very big scent throw at all. At all. It was just kind of junk. So Harmony Lane candles, would I buy it again? No. Next, I have a review item. This one was sent to me from Sentiments. I don't know if you can read that. They sent me their happy birthday one. This is in linen, and it's 100% soy. So again, it's one you will see in here that the wax got to a certain point, and then I ended up pouring out the wax because the wick moved over to the side, which is why you could see this big old black sooty mark. But I was in there trimming it. As you can see, the candle, the wick in there is super long. And that's because it had all the white part of that wick was all where it was filled to. It was to here before I had to give up on it because it totally melted, and then the wick kept moving off to the side, and that just spells danger to me. You know, like I said, I've had them crack and make huge messes and explode and all sorts of stuff. So when a wick starts moving around in there, I blow it out, I dump out the wax, even though there was a lot of life left to this. So that was the only downside I saw to this. But what you could do is just dump out the wax in a candle warmer thing. So that way you can still have your scent throw. It had a big scent throw. The linen did. And it's very clean. But it did have quite a bit of scent throw in it. So I was impressed. And the label is stinking cute too. Okay. Alyssa just finished this morning. She was making just a big old, lots of noise in there when she was trying to squeeze up the thing. But Act Kids, it's a fluoride rinse. It's one where you squeeze it till it fills the line, and then she drinks it out of the thing. This was hers. So yeah, she just finished this up. I do like to buy this just because I like the whole thing where you squeeze it, fill it up, and they get the precise amount, and then each of the kids have got their own, so then they can drink out of it all they want, and they don't have to worry about swapping cooties. But yeah, she just finished it. I would buy it again, for sure, because I keep buying it over and over and over again. This is probably, I don't know how many I've bought throughout the years. This is Axe Phoenix Shower Gel, one that my husband uses. It smells good. He likes it. I just talked about these products. Finish 9 by New Year's Finale. So I had my Avon Magi X Face Perfector, my Model Co. More Brows, and then I had my Avon Tropic Teal Eyeliner all used up. I've got a couple more makeup products. These ones were sent to me in a swap. Okay, first of all, it was this NYX Mega Shine in Pink Frost, and I never, when it came to me, it was like extremely, extremely dirty, to where the bow on the end, I mean, it was all brown. I mean, it was really, really dirty, and I was sitting there cleaning it all up, and then I'm like, okay, if it's that dirty, I don't even want to put it on my lips. So, and it seems a little on the thick side, like it's old. Yeah, it's old. Because I'm putting it in there and it's not covering the whole wand. So, yeah. Kind of a swap fail. I didn't really, really inspect it when I did my unbagging until afterwards. But yeah, I mean, I sat there and I was cleaning this up and I'm like, what the hell am I doing? Why am I cleaning up something that's really gross on the outside? How is it like on the inside? And then this matte, NYX matte lipstick in Shy Timid. And I've never used it, but you could see how dirty it is. And then the smell, it smells old, you know, like bad rice old. It just really stinks. I swatched it, but where is it? Oh, right here. I don't know if you could see. There's lines going up, and that's because it's so old, it's starting to dry out and it's cracking. Where is it? I want you to see that line. It's right. Can you see that line? Ooh. Well, of course you can't see it because that's where I put my nail. Kind of underneath where my nail mark is. But yeah, I didn't even put it on my lips. After doing my unbagging and stuff, I kind of did more of a closer look of inspection on the product and deemed it not wearable. And what I thought, you know, when I don't know. I don't want to go into it. I'm too nice, I guess. I'm too nice. I thought there was the rules were that you can swap new items or swatched items, or if they're used, you have to let them know that they're used, and then you have to sanitize them. And I don't mind sanitizing stuff, you know, like eyeshadows, blushes, that kind of stuff. It's easy to sanitize. Lipsticks, you know, you just cut the edge off. That's fine too. But this one, I wasn't even willing. Like my other one that I got, it was used, but I just lopped off the top of it and then I continued using it. It was fine. Yeah, I lost a lot of product doing that, but I'd rather do that. It's just safety precautions. So this one, I didn't even want to even lop off the top and go from there. I just didn't. I mean, it's just really old, it's stinky, and it's cracking because it's drying out. Sensodyne Pro Enamel Gentle Whitening. My husband uses this because he's got extremely sensitive teeth. He likes it, so I keep buying it. So yeah. And he uses his different toothpaste than I do. And I don't go through toothpaste as fast because I've got, you guys are gonna laugh at me, but I've got several things of toothpaste going on all at once. I try out samples constantly. I've got toothpaste in the shower. Yes, I do. I've got toothpaste in the shower because when I'm in a rush, I will brush my teeth in the shower. And then I've got my regular toothpaste, you know, at the bathroom sink. So that's why you will probably see more of my husband's stuff go through than mine, and just because I like using my samples up. I do. So this was one I just finished. It took me a little bit to finish it because I actually had this one in my shower. It replaced my other full one or semi-full one that's in the shower. This is Hello. I got this in a Walmart or Target beauty box, I want to say. This is in a Mojito Mint. And I thought it was going to be a really weird tasting, but I actually quite enjoyed it. I really liked it. Had enough minty to make me feel like I had a nice breath afterwards, but it had a little bit of lime to it, so I actually liked it. I did. Would I buy it? Yes. After I go through my huge stockpile, I've got a huge stockpile. I was a big couponer for a long time until my lady that I was buying my coupons from flaked on me, and now I haven't been doing it since July. Big, you know, my big stuff, but it's fine because I've just been using my back product and I've been going through it, so it's been nice. But yeah, I like this. Once I go through my back stock, I probably will buy it because I do like it. I liked it. I'm quite impressed, you know, I'm quite shocked with that. Talk to you guys later. Bye.